Hola
y bienvenida a Styling Your Lipstick. El pintalabio que tengo puesto para este video es by Fenty Beauty, the Gloss Bomb in Fussy.
I have an obnoxious amount of brand new makeup that I've been hiding from you. Obnoxious, obscene, and epic makeup haul. This box is full to the rim, so let's get into it, bitches. This one was a gift by my husband for Mother's Day. He got me a brand new makeup brush set by Cash Beauty. It looks so beautiful. When I saw it, I was like, oh my God, it looks so luxurious. It's all in black. It's so modern and chic and beautiful. And I wanted to get my hands on it. They're $100 and they're actually cheaper than the Sigma brushes, which is the ones that I've been using for like so many years, but I wanted to try something new. I haven't tried them yet, but I will keep you guys posted and let you know if they're worth it. And this is the second time that I purchased these lip glosses by Fenty Beauty. That's the one that I'm wearing today. It's called Fussy, the Gloss Bombs. I want to get them all sooner or later, but for now, I ended up getting this color and it's so stunning. I love their formula. It's very simple. It's glossy, it's shiny, it's no fuss to them, hence it's called Fussy. And the colors are just so stunning. I also ended up purchasing by Fenty Beauty one of their cream glosses, which is the first time I'm actually trying this out, and I saw this color and I am in love with it. It's so beautiful because it's like a caramel with a yellow undertone, and I love those type of colors because they give me like more of a grunge look and a different type of a nude coloring, and it's so beautiful. And the color you see here is exactly the color that you get on your lips. They're fully pigmented, beautiful, soft. This one is in the color Honey Waffles. Next is a foundation by Ilia. I love Ilia brand. I've actually purchased quite a few foundations by this brand. But for the summer, I wanted to try their skin tint, which is a SPF 40, because I've been using this for quite a while and I love it. I love the formula. I love how it feels on my skin. It gives me a beautiful, dewy look to my skin. It just looks so refreshed. It leaves no white cast whatsoever. It also comes with a tint. Even though the skin tint looks lighter than my skin tone, it disappears completely. It doesn't feel like I have anything on. It doesn't feel like I have makeup on. I'm so glad that I got it. Another foundation that I bought is by LYS, which stands for Love Yourself, and it's a black owned business. I love this foundation. This foundation feels heavier, but it's, to me, it's a medium to full coverage foundation. This is the type of foundation that I would wear when I want to really look pulled together and glamorous and way more flawless. Got the color TG5. Gives me sandy to slightly dewy type of finish. And I love this so much that I actually have a backup already. I've heard so much about this NYX finishing powder. I never really powder my face, but I do powder under my eyes when I use concealer so I could keep it in place. And so far I've been loving it. It does the job. It just mattifies everything and just keeps it nice and beautiful and flawless. It doesn't look like I have anything on. It's translucent. It's affordable. It's by NYX and it's really nice. So far it's been great. Another setting powder that I purchased is also by LYS. This is their banana powder and I love this one. It's also translucent, but compared to the NYX, it actually has a little bit more coverage. It's a little bit more yellow based and I love it because it just gives me such an ultra fine set look under my eyes. It just looks so flawless. This one is like the glamorous version of the NYX setting powder. This is a cream cheek blush by Milani. This one is in Cheek Kiss. I wanted to try one of their formulas with a cream finish. I haven't used it yet because I'm actually waiting for when I get a little bit more of a tan, because I feel like that's how it's gonna work better for me. I love the colors that they have there. I will keep you guys posted, but this is brand new and I wanted to see how it works. I purchased an eyeshadow palette. You're gonna die, oh my God, because I've been dying to get this and I finally got it. It's by Adept Cosmetics and I purchased this quite a few months ago and it finally arrived. Look at this packaging, gorgeous. sleek, slim, compact, modern, contemporary, and so chic. I ended up getting the Plain Jane eyeshadow palette because I love them either extra shimmery or super matte. And these just look so freaking sparkly and ridiculously beautiful. It's not even fun. These are ridiculous. It's so beautiful. I am obsessed with it. I can't wait to try this shit. Oh my God, it's so freaking beautiful. Oh my God. Next, Elamasqua is another brand that I love, and they were actually holding a sale on the website. As of today filming this video, they still have the sale going on, and I love their lipsticks because they have very unconventional colors and colors that I don't have in my collection. So I bought four of them. This is the Ultra Matte lipstick, which is a matte lipstick, and it's so stunning. It's called Base. This one is called Chara. Look how gorgeous this color is. Next, it's Climax, a velvety cool tone type of pink. So stunning. And then the last one is called Vela. It's so sexy. These freaking nudes are ridiculously sexy. Look at that. Just so gorgeous. One more, which I forgot, is also by Elamasqua. I ended up getting one of their lip gloss formulas, and this one is called Grime. I never tried their lip gloss formula, so I added one in there to see how it is. Fenty Beauty on their website was holding a sale, so I ended up purchasing some of their Mademoiselle lipsticks, which I love their matte formula. It's a beautiful formula. I ended up getting Freckle Fest, which is a stunning terracotta. I love colors like this. They were like $7. And then this one is called Violet Fury, which is like a purple color. I actually wore this one not too long ago. And because this was also on sale, I ended up getting one of the kilowatt foils. This one is Mimosa Sunrise and Sangria Sunset. First initial thought of this was like, oh my God, it's summer. When I get a tan, I can actually use these as blushes for like that bright, bold summer pop of color. I feel like it will be just so much fun. I haven't worn it yet because I'm still waiting for a tan and I'm still waiting for the summer. But I'm so excited to use this. I don't have colors like this. It's so fun. Oh my God. I ended up purchasing my first Dior product. This is the Dior Backstage Blush in Coral. Look at this freaking color. Who am I? Stunning. I already wore this and it's so beautiful. Coming across a little bit paler. It's actually a little bit more punchy. It's a coral peach type of color and it's so beautiful that I actually want to get the pink one too, but these are more expensive. There it goes. That's actually the truer color right there. See, it's a little bit more corally orange. So beautiful. Oh my God. It's my first Dior, bitches. Another purchase from LYS is their bronzer. LYS is the bomb.com because they're affordable. I mean, they just look luxurious. Their products are so substantial and they feel good and they are good. Their foundation is great. This bronzer is perfect. I love their banana powder. Just like everything that I tried by them, even their brushes. I bought their brushes. It's just super amazing. I got the color Courage, which is a tan color, and I've been using it, rocking it. It's beautiful. It gives me a perfect tan color. I use it all the time. It's not patchy at all. I ended up purchasing my first Givenchy product, and this is an eyeliner, tractable waterproof coal eyeliner in black, and I love this. It's super black. It stays on my waterline. I use it on my upper rim as well. I really love it. I almost don't want to love it because it's by Givenchy, but I wanted to try a different eyeliner to see if something would work better. What have I done? What have I done? Because now I love this one and it's by Givenchy, so you know it's not inexpensive, which really sucks. I hope you guys enjoyed and I will see you in my next video.